Deo. Ibade, Ibade, Ibade. Ibade light come and me want to go home. De. Badeo. How you doing, man? I hope you be all right. I hope you got your coconut cart open, man. You got your stroll inside and you're drinking up on the coconut water. The healthiest water they ever be on the face of the earth. 1 month of healthy coconut water, your blood be as pure as beer as a baby. Ooh, Briakasha. They say Azra, he's America. Okay, we go. Yeah. Hessen is coming. Continued from Hessen is coming. Hey, Briakasha, let's listen, call.
Through that country, there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half, and the same region is called Arsareth, which means another land. Arsareth means another land, okay? Which are the Americas, okay? Canada, North America.
Well, it's funny he said Canada first, because when he say Azarath is Canada, right? And you see in the name Azarath, Sarah, right? And I always bring this up. You travel up to New York, start texting people, you start type in Saranac, Saratoga, Saratoga Springs, Saranac River, Syracuse. And then while you're texting somebody, your little hand device constantly tries to tell you Syria, right? And you sit there and you do the Mount Ephraim thing, and Mount Ephraim's up there in Vermont, you know? So, you know, to a great degree, that's believable to me. Again, I know of the Azores Islands. I understand when Dumb Diversus, they say, blob 103 degrees longitude by or something like that, you know, off of the Azores Islands. So, I'm just gonna listen.
Mexico, you could say, Central America, and South America, man. Okay. And it says, then dwelt they there until the latter time, and now when they shall begin to come. So it said that the Northern Kingdom, the 10 tribes, which is 9 now because Dan doesn't exist as a tribe anymore, these tribes will be here in Arsareth until the end times. That's why they're still over here, man. All right? So how much proof do you need, man? Okay?
Hi, Shalom. This is the word Azareth, okay? And I'm just going to build on the intro and what you saw in the beginning. And I'm just going to get right into it. All praise, honor, and glory to our Vice Shemar Shah Barakatha. It says, the name of the land beyond the great river, far away from the habitation of man, in which the 10 tribes of Israel will dwell, observing the laws of Moses until the time of the restoration, according to 2 Ezra, the 13th chapter, the 45th verse. It says, Columbus identify America with this land. So let's read the verse real quick. It's 2 Ezra 13:45. For through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half, in the same region is called Arsareth. Okay. And this is from the Euphrates River, okay, and this being the year and a half journey, okay, to the Americas, right? So this is another definition, and I'll leave all these links along with the brother's lessons, because really that's what inspired me to build on top of the information that was already provided to him through the Spirit. So this is Arsareth. Says the King James Version, Arsareth, this is the land to which the 10 tribes were deported, 2 Ezra 13:45, which we just read. It is described as another land lying a year and a half's journey beyond the river, i.e. the Euphrates. And the reason why this is important when it talks about beyond the river and the Euphrates, and I'm kind of alluding to something here I'm about to cover, but the point being is anytime it's spoken of in the ancient terms regarding the scriptures,
Well, typically during the time of 600 to 400 BCE, the people were gone beyond the river. And it says it probably answers to the Hebrew Eretz or Akeretz in Deuteronomy 29 and 28. In Josephus's time, the people were still believed to be there in countless numbers. And then this is the Antiquities of Josephus, the 11th chapter, so like the 11th volume, the 5th chapter, and the second verse. But I'm going to cover this Deuteronomy chapter 29 and 28. Says, "And the Lord rooted them out of their land in anger and in wrath and in great indignation, and cast them into another land as it is this day," which is basically the root for the word Eteretz, or Eteretz, Eteretz, okay? And that another land is spoken of as America, okay? That is where they left from the Euphrates. And so...
Hold on, let's go back for a second. Now you see... and in great indignation, and cast them into another land unto this day. There it says, Eretz, right? Now, if somebody that does etymology can look up what Eretz means and see what it says in Hebrew, and see how this says A-C-H-E-R-E-T-H, E-R-E-T-S. So they a lot of places don't put... Basically, it's another way to spell it. You see up here it says Zer-F. Up here it goes Er-Etz. Or ache, right? You use the Egyptian brother ache, A-C-H, or pain, right? Ache. I've got an ache, A-C-H. You got E-R-E. T, and here it says E-R-T-S, Eretz, right? So, just keep that in mind as we see different places that end E-R-E-T-S.
Eteretz, or Eretz, Eteretz, okay? And that another land is spoken of as America, okay? That is where they left from...
All right, we're all guilty of this. The other land that's spoken of is not say it's America. What the scripture does say, let's look at it again. As it is this day, rooted them out of their land as it is this day. So it's as if this is written about in the past, but it's written to show you that presently you are still in this condition, as this is the time the Bible is valid to you. Isn't that weird? Written thousands of years ago, before they were rooted out, this was written. Even the part, as it is to this day. I'm sure when they heard that 1,000 years ago, they start scratching their heads, say, "Oh, we're not rooted out."
As it is this day.
Let's go back forward.
The cause of the king's great favor to him, and that for the same reason he gave all the thanks to Yahweh. So he read the epistle at Babylon to those Jews that were there, but he kept the epistle itself and sent a copy of it to all those of his own nation that were in Media. And when these Jews had understood what piety the king had towards Yahweh and what kindness he had for Ezra's, they were all greatly pleased. Nay, many of them took their effects with them and came to Babylon as very desirous of going down to Jerusalem. But then the entire body of the people of Israel remained in that country.
In Babylon.
Wherefore, there are but two tribes in Asia, in Europe, subject to the Romans. And really, this is three tribes, because it was Judah, Benjamin, and Levi.
Got it.
Okay, that was still in subjection underneath the Romans, the Greeks, and the Assyrians at that time. It says, while the 10 tribes are beyond Euphrates till now and are in immense multitude and not to be estimated by numbers. Okay, and so that goes back to prove that in the Josephus, in which
reading, see if he continues to read that,
in which was spoken, and this is in the in the Josephus.
Let's hold on. Esdras had said beforehand that he, beforehand that he had told the king how God would preserve them, and so he had not thought fit to request that he would be sent, he would send horsemen to conduct them. So when they had finished their prayers, they had removed from the Euphrates on the 12th day of the first month of the 7th year of the king of reign of Xerxes, and they came to Jerusalem on the 5th month of the same year. Now Esdras presented the sacred money to the treasurers of who were of the family of the priest, of silver 650 talents, vessels of silver 100. Okay, so he gives him money, presents, and had been made by the king and his counselors and by all the Israelites that stayed at Babylon. So then Esdras, something I delivered and delivered these things to the priest, he gave to God as the appointed sacrifice of whole burnt offerings. 12 bulls on the account of the... Okay, so you see he gave them finance to be able to leave while other people stayed in Babylon. And that is not that the situation we're dealing with. We have a GoFundMe. Right now I'm taking the role. I'm sitting in the role as the priest. We are saving money. We're gaining money for land exploration and purchase, so that we can make an attempt to go unto this new place. We are actually reliving history. And because we choose to not study, we don't respect it that way.
Another country in which was spoken, and this is in the Jewish encyclopedia, and even Christopher Columbus, it says, identified America with this land. And so I'm going to finish out here, because basically this is just the excerpt from the Jewish encyclopedia, and I'm going to read this again. This is Azariath. It says, the name of the land beyond the great river, speaking of Euphrates, far away from the habitation of man, in which the 10 tribes of Israel will dwell. Okay, meaning that year and a half journey, okay, as is spoken of in 2 Ezra's before.
Whoa, is he going to continue? Okay, he's going to continue.
45th verse, the 13th chapter. For through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half, and the same region is called Arsareth. And it says, observing the law of Moses unto the time of the restoration.
Is that not what we are attempting to do? We're actually attempting more. Not only are we going to observe the laws of the Creator brought to us by Moses, we're going to try to actually observe the body of Moses itself. And hopefully he'll be wrapped like a mummy, and hopefully he'll be holding something that we can somehow understand how to read from and resurrect him.
According to 2 Ezra 13, 45, Columbus identified America with this land. And so, yeah, like I said, I just wanted to cover that real quick. Like I said, I was inspired by the brothers' video. So, Lord willing, this is edifying for the elect. Once again, all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Shemir, Shabbat, Rakatah.
No offense.
Which are the Americas.
just don't share that name.
For through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half, and the same region is called Arsareth, which...
So it's through that country.
...means another land. Arsareth means another land, okay? Which are the Americas, okay? Canada, North America, Mexico, you could say, Central America, and South America, man, okay? And it says, then dwelt they there until the latter time. Over here, man. All right? So how much proof do you need, man? Okay?
This is the end of Apocalypto. He escapes from the pyramids, right? These, whoever these people are controlling the pyramids, even though we see that the Judeans made themselves temples, whether they say that Jacob's children are on the other side of the world, whether they say that Judah's children are on the other side of the world, this Bible says that they made kings of themselves. End of Apocalypto. Guess who shows up? Now, they're running to capture this person that was supposed to be executed, right? The star of the movie. Now, what they're about to see has stopped them in their tracks. They no longer want to execute this motherfucker. Because what they see astonishes them. And what is it that they see? See their faces? They're all dead. It doesn't matter that they're trying to sacrifice one to appease the gods. It doesn't matter that they collected all these different types of Indian groups and started sacrificing them. They already fucked up. The Bible says they pickled the bodies. They devoured them. And for devouring them, the devil comes. And when you see the devil, you already know your future. It's over. It's all over. Looking at each other, we're fucking dead. Who are the Spaniards? They came with the sword. Did you see them in the mist? Do you see them in the dew? In the fog? What'd they do? They came with the swords. They took the silver, they took the gold, they took the booty. L DNA. Everyone has L female DNA right now. We're not at the beginning of time. We're at the end. The end of time. How does everybody have the same DNA? L. L1, L2, L3. How? Because of slavery. A new author has arisen. One video.
Hey everybody, I had some family things to take care of, so I apologize for taking so long to make another video. Good things, nothing bad. It's that time of the year, gotta take care of some personal stuff. So I just wanted to hit up this Psalms 1, first Psalms, and it's a pretty short song, it's only 6 verses. So this is not going to be a long video. I'm just going to kind of read it and go through it. Unlike what I usually do is, break out, the dictionary and everything else, to really dig in deep into the meat of things, I think this is a pretty self-explanatory. So in any case, here we go. excuse me. Blessed. You know what? I know people say blessed, but I say blessed. Sorry. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. Don't take your advice from ungodly folk. Nor standeth in the way of sinners. Don't get anywhere. If somebody's a sinner and you recognize that they're a sinner, they can do what they do, because they're sinners. So you'll be blessed for it. Nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. You know, it's kind of interesting. Because what do they say about women? What's the cliche? A woman scorned. So this kind of makes me think that, you know, not that men can't be scornful, but how, you know, the chosen of Christ, the chosen of God, you know, God's people, is always referred to in the feminine. And so, you know, and then we read, Numbers? You know, that's all I do is murmur. Or is it Judges? So, yeah.
He said all he do is murmur, as he murmured it. All right, so Irvin Reed is now on the dance floor, the fashion floor, and Irvin's got some videos. Let's see how many uploads he's got. I don't know why it's doing that. It's not like showing me all the uploads. All right, so Irvin's got 8 uploads. We are behind on Irvin's uploads. Irvin, you waited too long to say, I'm making uploads. All right. So, Irvin's got an opinion and a Bible, and he is ready to get on the thrashing floor. Now, well, we're watching Psalms 1, Stay in Your Lane. And as, you know, he's talking about, these are the things we should watch out for. So, buckle up our safety belts, and as we're driving, stay out of those people's lanes. When we started watching...
Through that country, there was a great...
Through that country, there was a great way to go. Azarath is America, continued from hasten his coming. So we were watching that. Now, I'm just trying to show you other people are out there. We might not be saying the same thing, but we all want the same goal. Now, I don't want this video to be too long, so I'm not going to, you know, show you all the complete seconds of everybody's video. Now, these men are trying to assist you. Now, I'm going to show you someone that I do not feel is trying to assist you. Now, I've told you to watch people as they pop up so you can judge for yourself. It's not that hard to judge what people do when it's wrong. This isn't you sitting on your side of the computer with a fucking stone saying, I dare you to fuck up. I dare you to fuck up. Because all you're going to do is smash your computer. This is knowing when to trust people and when not to trust people. Now, when we look at Khalil Saeed, he's made videos showing that Hayah backwards is Allah. Now, he states that he shows videos that he shows you topics that nobody shows you. I have a video, you can check the date versus his video of in comparison. I've told you a long time ago that these names are Hayah backwards. Yah is Hayah backwards. Allah is Hayah backwards. Doing research, we found out Allah is actually Azazel. This man makes videos saying, I want to go through heaven, not through the front door, not through the imaginary Christian St. Peter's Gate. I want to find a window. I want to find a balcony type shit. And what do you think the Most High thinks when people make those kind of statements? When we record our statements, are they decrees? To some degree, are they written in digital history? Can you, if all this digital information goes to another dimension, one day will we be able to comb through that dimension and look at all the digital stuff that everybody's ever made? This man made a comment saying he wants credit. He wants credit for tricking people into thinking Allah and Haya are the same. When clearly, if one is reversed from the other, then one's a root and one is a refraction. You stand in the mirror, you hold a pen in your right hand, the mirror image looks like you're holding a pen in your left hand, right? Something to that degree. Even if I'm saying it wrong, you still kind of got the gist of what I'm saying. So, he has publicly been teaching people that Allah and Haya are the same. When we can go into Muslim writings or Islamic writings and see that they replaced the Israelites with the children of Isaac. So they're not the same. They're just like the Christians, as the Christians replaced the Israelites with themselves. So every time we bring this stuff up, this guy finds a new way to try to trick people. This guy makes threats. Hey, come to California. Come to fucking Crenshaw. Who the fuck wants to go to California? If anybody wanted to go to California, they'd already fucking wet. Anybody that wants to go to California today is only to be in the fucking movies. When they get to California, they ain't getting in the goddamn movies. So it's just silliness. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to highlight some shit. Because we, and everybody that makes videos showing the evidence for this fact, we've been highlighting Utah. And this man has decided that he's going to try to stop us. There's no point in saying anything threatening. There's no point in saying anything ridiculous about it, because the man is just a fool. Now, we are Afro peoples, or Afro people groups. Whether we call ourselves black, whether we call ourselves African American, whether we call ourselves Negro. And there's a problem with us because we have been taught lies and we've been taught tricks. There's been social programming to make us think a particular way. Now, some of us have been tricked so bad we ignore our own brain, how it works, how it functions. We should believe someone can come and whisper in our ear and it can make us think that our eyes are lying to us. Now, this man made a video. Okay, first off, he made a new channel. Somehow, he's so upset that of his old channel, he decided to make a new channel. Alright? Now, somebody said to me, hey, you should see one of his videos that he made. It says, Utah Aztecs are Edomites. Now, we're going to watch this movie that he made, this little video, and it's 10 minutes long. And I'm going to show you what he says, and then we'll turn the camera back around and we'll talk about it.
Now, what did they say?
Give me one second. Oh.
Where people are going. People are going to, well, they, some people believe, some, that some people are going to congregate in Utah.
Okay, so here we have somebody in other people's business who's not happy because of his views. Now, when you listen to his video, Lex Will leaving his mama's house, he sit there just like everybody else. I'm mad because of his views. We're going to take a listen to the Nightmare Podcast. We're going to listen to Lex Will is a Flat Earther. And when the host hears how many subscribers I have compared to the host, he gets distant and sad. Now, this fool does the same thing. Now, let's listen.
And, I wanted to show you...
I wanted to try to stop you from going to Utah with some dumb shit. Now watch.
What's actually happening here? If you look in Psalms 83 and 6, it states, the tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagarenes. Now... I can show you this genetically.
Okay. Now he states he can show us this genetically. Now we're going to watch him show us genetically.
Now watch this. The tabernacles...
Now he goes back to the world map of Y DNA haplogroups, right?
Of Edom are Q2.
Okay. Now here's my question. Now, I have a very valid question. Where in any history book, where in any teaching manual, where in anything that it does has to do with haplogroups, does it say Q is Edom? This is my question. This is a very valid question. For some person to say, I'm going to teach black people, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do that, all he's going to do is lift his finger, and he's going to point. You're not going to read nothing. He's just going to open his mouth. So when you say, show me evidence, all this dude is going to do is blah, 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 blah. Now he said, I can show you. Let's hear what he said again. What did he say? I show you.
And the Hagarenes. Now, I can show you this genetically.
I can show you genetically. And what did he do? He went to a fucking haplogroup map. White man says this. Then you are. Here's the problem. On the fucking haplogroup, the white man doesn't say nothing about Edom. Not one thing. Pick a nation that's supposed to be Edom. Now, he done read to you that Chittim is supposed to be Edom. Even though Chittim is actually Japhet, and Edom mixed with Japhet, so you're going to get Edom and Japhet blood back. See, this is the problem when somebody don't give a fuck about you. Now, it's true, I can't see you. But something about me cares about you. Alright? And that's why I'm making these videos. Wow, well, let me do that. So, what I want you to understand is just because this dude point and say, blah, 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 evidence and verification needs to be shown. Now, we're going to spin this around and we're going to listen to him try to finesse you. Now, he went to the Bible, right, and said the tabernacles of Ishmael the tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab. So, Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagarenes. Ishmael is living on Moab's land. When this was written. Does that mean when slavery occurred, Ishmael was pushed in with us? We have perceptions about how everybody looked. Everybody's black. But what if everybody's not? Now, just because it says of Moab doesn't mean they live there today. Just because it says of Moab, does that mean that the Lord didn't give us that land? Now, I'm going to read this again, since he used the Bible, but didn't go anywhere with it. He just read one. I'm going to read one, too. Okay? Are you ready? You heard his one. Are you ready for my one? One! There. Deuteronomy 32,
and 49. Get thee up into this mountain Abarim, unto Mount Nebo, which is in the land of Moab. So, is there some confusion? We're talking about the same fucking place, right? The tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagarines. It doesn't say Moabites of Moab. It says Ishmaelites of Moab. What happened to the Moabites? Which is in the land of Moab that is over against Jericho. And behold, the land of Canaan. Canaan Mountain is there. Cain County is there. Which I gave unto the children of Israel as a possession. Did you hear that? Now, watch what this goddamn devil does.
Okay, now watch this. The tabernacles of Edom are Q2.
Where the evidence besides him just saying that on camera? How come when I scroll down in the comments, don't nobody say prove it? He's got 8 thumbs up. I'm going to show you when we watch all 10 minutes of this, he didn't prove anything. Oh, so the comments don't want to load. Hold on 1 second. Here's his comments on this video. Now, I state 2 days ago, where exactly do you prove that Q2Y DNA is Edom? I missed that part. So 2 days, he didn't let that, he usually deletes my comments. 2 days, he gonna not comment. This little homo, right? As soon as he came out with this campaign, what does that have to do with what his fucking video is about? All you do is go and talk shit like it's fucking Facebook. And then this dude, here he go again. Ha, wow, LOL. Hey, I shared your video to people, Khalid Saheed. We may disagree in the earth topic, but I don't hate you. Oh, oh. So great job, Shaman, right? Somebody leaves a fucking link, right? And that guy is definitely on a power trip, right? Okay, so these guys are all what you call nut huggers. They want to sit in the pocket of his underwear by his testicles. Again, where exactly does he prove Q2 DNA is of Edom? Now, we're 49 seconds and we were at 52. We'll go.
Our Q2. Q2 right there, right? But they also see the pink, purplish. They also traveled over here to the Americas with us. And those tabernacles of Edom, I'm going to show you right now. They are your QM2. And if you look, who the QM2 is right here.
So, this is what he did. He went to Wikipedia, Y-DNA, right? That's all he did. Y-DNA, Indigenous Peoples of the Americas, right? Algonquin, right? Here's C, here's Q, here's R, right? Others, and this is all they want to give you. Now, you know that your black ass is Indigenous to America, and they only want to give you C, Q, and R. Now, you'd have to ask why they only give C, Q, and R. Everything else is under other, but still only show you C, Q, and R. Now, when we go down to Apache, it is Q DNA, right? Cherokee is M3. Cherokee, 50% Q. Now, look, Cherokee, 46% R. Chib Chan, 100% Q. Now, you've never seen that. So this becomes these people of Panama, the macro Chib, whatever they are, they become important because they are non-intermixed.
They're Afro-Asian. They are marginalized, right? What happens when we go to Afro-Asian? Term can also refer to modern descendants of Aboriginal, mostly uncontacted. Now, I have no evidence that Chib Chan is this color, that color, or anything, but it's 100% their own fucking DNA, which means they are uncontacted. Look at the Chippewa, 17% Q, so they're contacted, 79% R1B. It's R1B or just R, R1. You know, it's R1B or R1A, right? Out of Africa, no matter what, whether it's European out of Africa or Arab out of Africa. So all these things are Q for the most part. QQ. Maya, 87% Q. So when you see the Maya, and you know they were black, and they're 87% Q, this dude says they're fucking what? What did he say? Q2, so that means they're what?
Are Q2.
So they're EDOM.
Q2 right there, right?
That's what he said.
But they also see the pink, purplishly. They also traveled over here to the Americas with us. And those tabernacles of EDOM, I'm going to show you right now.
Now, you can see that the Maya was here before Columbus. They also traveled over here with us. Maya were here before Columbus. And here's their fucking DNA. And it's what? 87% Q. So they were mixing, just like the Bible says, even though the Bible doesn't say the name Maya, they were mixing before Columbus came. Here's the mix. Now, when you ask who the Mixe or the Mix people are, they are of the Sierra Mix, the Ocoxa, Mexico. Any pictures? Of course not. But these Mix people are indigenous groups inhabiting the eastern highlands of the Mexican state of Oaxaca. They speak the Mixe language, which are classified as the Mixe Zoku family and are more culturally conservative than other indigenous groups. So the word Mix itself probably came from the Nahuatl word for cloud, Mixly. Now, here's another people group. These people, the Chib Chan, are 100% them fucking selves. They're not intermixed with anybody, and they probably run around with rules. If you intermix them, a fucking could kill you. So, here you have the classification and where they're located. When you go down and you see, I just saw the Rama. The Rama is a village in Nicaragua. Now, the Rama deal with the Rama people. Now, the Rama people don't look like you. Rama people, they are Canaanites. When you type in Rama and then people, right? Let's go to images. See, I've done this lesson before. Right? Journey by boat to Rama. Rio Ingo Indigo Lodge. Only 15 to 20 people now speak the Rama language. Rama K Creole. So, this is YouTube. Bye bye, more something. By Zambian people with. So, those are Zambian people. Those aren't Rama people. Ministry of Housing addressing something. Nicaragua's Rama Indian face. So, Henry Albert Presidia, who identifies with Nicaragua's Rama indigenous group. Okay? So he identifies with them. Now, these are the Rama people. The Rama people worshipped Ashtaroth from when I did my lesson dealing with the Rama people. They were part of the people of Tyr, I believe. And those are Canaanites from my studies. So until you're going to show... See, you done said that when we get down to the Aztec... Now look at this. Now the Seminole, right here. See, this is what I saw on his screen. Seminole Indians, right here. East North Americans. 45% Q, 50% R1. Sioux, 25% Q, 50% R1. South American American Indian, Q, M3. 4% R1. So he went down, and he went down to the Uto Aztec, right? You have the Uto Aztec at 93.4 and 6%. Now, when we go to realhistory.com, and we type in Aztec, Ancient Americans on Real History. Aztec Real History. Now, we've been here recently. Now, we've seen those people. Right? And then we start hearing about the Aztec physical appearance. Here is a 16th century Spanish description. The people of this land are well made, rather tall than short. They are swarthy as leopard. That's a swarthy leopard. Black. Remember we started arguing about last names from a viewer's comment, an excellent comment he made. How does Schwarzenegger have a black name when he's white? Swarthy as leopards. Of good manners and gestures. Oh, they're savages. Of good manners. For the greater part, very skillful. They're athletes. Robust, they're athletes. They're tireless, they're athletes. And at the same time, the most moderate men known. The intellectual athletes. I'm a dunk on you. Cool. They are very warlike and face death with the greatest resolution. Both leopards and jaguars are not usually dark. They are swarthy. Not dark. They're swarthy. The writer must therefore be referring to those that are melanistic, completely black or very dark. They are known as Black Panthers. Okay, so if that's the characteristics, why do we have these people that are yellow-esque? So you have to start asking these questions. I'll be right back. All right, so we go to... We just came to realhistory.com. We typed in Aztec, and it's under the Americas. Again, we see these people here. And when we scroll down, it talks about the physical appearance. And as swarthy as leopards, swarthy is dark, right? So when we look at these, they don't show dark Aztec. They show yellow Aztec. And I don't have any problem with that. It's just that they show the Aztec is when we look over here, at the Y DNA haplogroups of the Uto Aztec. Uto. Now, there's two things to note about the Aztec. The UTE are one type of Aztec. See, this is why you don't fuck with somebody that sits there and studies all their goddamn life. And the UTO is a different type of Aztec. Now, Uto Aztec and the Ut Aztec. These are not misspellings, these are not mispronunciations. You say that, see the UTE comes back for the Uto, right? But what is the Southern Ute tribe? So there's two different tribes. And nobody's gonna tell you this. How is there two different tribes of the same fucking family, but they look differently? Won't we prove that they look differently? Okay, I will. There's an Aztec, right? Well, they say that's an Olmec, right? With a feathered serpent, right? So there's a serpent, right? And then they claim that's the old Olmec sitting there with Aztec garb on and shit, right? Okay, so here's what you have. This is the Cholu style female figurine representing the corn goddess Chicumcotl, holding the sun's rays, right? That looks very Negro to me. Now here is another Aztec. You see it says Aztec right underneath. Now if this is an Aztec, why the fuck are Aztec making stone images of Negroes or Africans or blacks? They're not. They're making images of themselves. So, rise of the Aztecs. Okay, so here we have Aztec 1400 AD. Zacpilti or something was the Aztec god of music and dance. His name is Nahuatl. The language spoken by the Aztecs means flower prince. So, when you look at these two, this is their fucking god, right? This is the name, right? Language spoken by the Aztecs. I'm sorry, god of music. Excuse me. This is the god of music, not their god. Their god of music. Does that mean he's the chief musician? No, he's just their god of music. All right, is that a nigga face? Is that a Negroid face? Is that an African face? Is that a non-Mongoloid face? Is that a non-Asianic face? Based on what we've learned from Caucasoids, what Asians are? Look at the face next to him. See the Negro skin? Right? We already know, we've seen these suits, right? They're wearing their enemy's skin, right? You can see the man's skin. It's just a clay figurine. You can see this is the skin draped on him like a shirt. And you can see he's wearing a mask. You see his lips. You can see the enemy's mask lips on the outside, right? Ain't those the real lips right there? Ain't those nigga lips? These are the Aztecs making images of themselves. I'm gonna ignore that proxy shit. Here you go, Mixtec gold pennant. Boy, that's a nigga with a beard. Right? Right. It says Monte Albin, 300 to 400 AD. These don't look like, that's big nigga lips. So, you can go ahead and believe they DNA if you want. I don't give a fuck. Tio Hukan, right? Ukan. Kanan, Kan, Ukan. Whatever. Now, it don't matter if they Canaanites or Israelites. Because when you go to the fucking DNA that this nigga wants you to look at, that he just points and says, oh, these is Edom. You see their DNA is, you know, they have mixed DNA. 93% one thing, which is a very high standard, right? They are 93% Q2. And then a 6% R1B. Now, I want you to understand, if I do a DNA test, my DNA test is going to come back as one of these things. I am talking bad about haplogroups because I do not believe in these bullshits. So if it comes back and say, hey, you got MT fucking L DNA, L2, no big surprise, I just read it. If it comes back and says Q, I'm not going to be surprised. I live in America.
If it comes back and says R1B, I'm not going to be surprised. When it comes back and says, I'm African, I'm not going to be surprised, because the standards that have been set into place for us to look at it this specific way. But I'm not going to point to fucking blood groups and say, this is that based on my opinion, and this is that based on my opinion. When I point to shit, when I put the shit on screen, I show you at least one way to verify, if not two ways to verify. The problem is we're classified as dumb niggas, and people think because we're classified as dumb niggas, we can't think. Listen, motherfucker, just because you point at the goddamn screen and say, this is EDOM, don't mean it's EDOM. And don't get me wrong, just because I make a video saying, because you pointed at the screen, don't make it EDOM. You need evidence. Just like I'm going to use the rest of your little 10-minute video as evidence that you are lying. And you're going to have to make another channel again. Seems the shaman of Shem, the self-named shaman of Shem, is a fucking liar. Well, it's midnight around here. Baby's already up. So let's get back to this fucking liar's video. Sweet bitch.
They are your QM2. And if you look, who the QM2 is right here, it happens to be Uto Aztecan. Uto Aztecan, see, they're 93.4%.
Okay, I'm gonna go back up to this this Y DNA thing, okay? So I'm gonna hit the top. All right, this is the top of it. Now it says, listed here are notable indigenous peoples of America by human Y chromosome DNA haplogroups based on relevant studies. The samples are taken from individuals identified with qDNA must be EDOM. No, it doesn't fucking say that. With ethnic and linguistic designations in two columns. The fourth column, N, is the sample size study, how many people were in the group, and the other column given are the percentage of the particular halogroup. Okay? So C is the study of that particular haplogroup, is the percentages in that haplogroup. Nowhere does it say Q belongs to EDOM. So his words, the Algonquin Indians are EDOM. Apache Indians have qDNA. The qDNA is higher in Apache. They must be EDOM too. Athabascan, 70% Q. They must be EDOM. Cherokee, 32%. They can't be EDOM because they're only 2% and 17%. Cherokee, they're 50% EDOM because this fucking moron says so. Not the study he's reading from. Now, an intelligent person would say, oh, these people are from the same group. They would say, oh, Abraham's related to Isaac. Isaac's related to Jacob. Jacob's related to the 12 tribes. They're related to Edom. To some degree, they should all have the same DNA haplogroup. You don't hear a goddamn person saying that, do you? Not a one.
Sit. Aztecs are Edomites.
Where's your evidence? You're just saying that. And then you're just doing a gay sigh. Let's listen to the gay sigh again.
Aztecs are Edomites.
Prove it.
This is the problem a lot of people are going to have. And look,
your lack of evidence is the problem I would think that a lot of people are going to have. All you did was point and open your mouth. Aztecs or Edomites. Show me on the same fucking shit you're reading where it says Edom anywhere. Show me where it says Canaan anywhere. Show me where it gives a biblical name for any of these goddamn people groups that are gifted to us from the Most High. Uto Aztecan.
Naha, Nahua, are Uto Aztecans. Papengo are Uto Aztecan. Did you know this? Or did you think the Aztec were one fucking group? Like I did. Uto Aztecan, Uto Aztecan. So let's look at this list and see everything that says Uto Aztecan. Uto Aztecan, right? Mexico, Arizona. Didn't know they were up in Arizona, did you? No, me neither. Papago. Uto Aztecan. Nuha. Nahu, whatever. Uto Aztecan. So this guy went to one group, said it's all the Aztecs, and blah, blah, blah. When you can clearly see, even though they all say they have fucking Q or a percentage of Q, which really doesn't matter. What matters is when you start studying the Aztecs and you start understanding that there are different blood groups to the Aztec. Let's see. The woman depicted is obviously not an Aztec woman, but in that it depicts the woman of Mongo extraction, it more likely reflects La Malinke's true identity. And you see here is a light-skinned nigga. Then put the man down. Then put the man down. The man that has the same color contexture as this woman that's being called Mongoloid or Mongol. So this man is taking the woman from the Mongol, and obviously he's about to what? Reproduce with the Mongol. So you see they got this ancient fucking image of this ancient effing Negro about to F this lady when he done effed up her dude. Hey man. So you can listen, we are a minute and 37 seconds in and he ain't proved shit.
What they say, look what it says. They're Uto Aztecan.
Whoa!
In Mexico. Now let's go to the map. Let's see where Arizona is.
Oh, let's act like we wasn't born in a goddamn United States. Like we can't figure out where the fuck Arizona is. Now listen. Why would you need somebody to show you where fucking Arizona is when his goal is to show you Aztecs or EDOM? It's called sleight of hand. I'm going to distract you for a few minutes. While I don't make my fucking point. So he says Aztecs or EDOM and he shows you Arizona.
Arizona. Here's Mexico.
Whoa!
And where's Uto? Uto is Utah.
Whoa! Look at that! When you go to DNA and it tells you Uto Aztecan, it says Arizona and Mexico. It does not even tell you Utah. Oh my god, that must mean they're fucking Edom.
You have the Aztecs. Aztecs are Edomites.
Where the fuck does he prove this? All he's done over and over again is say, I'm sorry, Aztecs are Edom. Is this motherfucker really telling you he's teaching you something by showing you a fucking map? What on the map says Edom? All the map he showed you was, is that the same thing? They live in Mexico and they live in Arizona. Whoa, so he goes you to, takes you to the map and says, hey, here's Arizona. Believe it or not, they also live in Utah. Oh, because of this fucking premise, they must be Edom. Wait, he used the Bible scripture out of context too, that said the Ishmaelites of Edom, of Moab. This must be the point he's making, right?
I just proved it to you.
Did you fucking hear that? 2 minutes and 24 seconds is all he needed to prove it, right? Let's go back one whole minute. Let's half this shit.
M2 is right here. It happens to be Uto Aztecan. Uto Aztecan. See, they're 93.4%. Aztecs or Edomites? This is the problem a lot of people are going to have. And look what they say. Look what it says. They're Uto, Aztecan, Arizona, and Mexico. Now let's go to the map. Let's see where Arizona is. And we're going to see where Mexico is. And we're going to see where Uto is. Whoa. Don't go too fast on it, brother. Now here's Arizona. Here's Mexico. And where's Uto? Uto is Utah. You have the Aztecs. Aztecs are Edomites. I just proved it to you.
Okay, 2 minutes and 24 seconds. Now we listen to a whole minute and 10 seconds of him say the fucking same nonsense where he ain't proved. He just said, listen, oh my God. Hey, listen, if your girlfriend was cheating on you and you found another man's genital fluid all over and you knew that wasn't your fluid, it would be enough evidence. You could then say, look, that's the evidence. If you found a man's drawers on the floor, you're going to be saying, I don't have those. That's the evidence. If you saw the motherfucker jumping out of the window, you can say, that's the evidence. But if you look on a map and you're trying to say it's Edom, and when you went to the Bible, it didn't tell you it's Edom. When you went to your DNA bullshit, it didn't tell you the name Edom anywhere. When you went to the Bible, you took it out of fucking context. It says these nations, what? Made a bond, a pact against you. It doesn't mean they're still in that location. I don't know how to say somebody's really fucking stupid unless I use the words somebody's really fucking stupid. For 8 people to thumb this fucking video up and he ain't proved not a fucking thing, that means there's 8 really stupid people that'll do anything for this guy. Now we're gonna watch the rest of the 8 immensely stupid fucking minutes of this video. And at some point, if somebody feels that he proved Edom is in Utah or Arizona, or that he proves that Aztecs are Edom, let me know, because I must have cut up my brain today and eaten part of it as cake, and that means that I can't think right. And when he says I'm proving it for you, I'm just not fucking seeing it. In fact, I've got to point the finger at this sorry motherfucker and say liar. And then, at the end of this video, I'm gonna have to lay down stipulations. And that's what it's come to.
Oh, they're Uto. They're from Utah. That must mean Edom.
The Tabernacles of Edom. You're an Aztec. Who else is in there? The Ishmaelites. But Ishmaelites, I proved to you, are Muslims. So a lot of Ishmaelites are converts, and that's your haplogroup R.
Didn't this motherfucker come on camera and say his stepdad's a Muslim and he worships Islam, or however they fucking phrase that bullshit? Like, this dragon don't even need a second fucking face. Like, look how he done, I chopped this scripture into pieces, and I'm going to use this one line. I'm going to take it out of context and say Edom is of Moab.
Let's go to why DNA of haplogroup R. Of Native Americans. Haplogroup R, a large percent of percentage of them are your Cherokee, and out of the Cherokee come the Choctaw, and that's what Tanya Moore, and they own slaves. Very interesting. So you have, in this verse, you have Edom, the Aztecs, Ishmaelites, the haplogroup are Indians, and that's why, and the black Indians, the Cherokee, and the branches that come out of them, and that's why they're calling themselves the Moors and Muslims, because they are converts into that. That they did bring that.
Now, if anybody knows of black Cherokee Indians calling themselves Moors, can you let me know? So I can talk about this on camera. That would be good. If anybody knows about black Cherokee Indians calling themselves Moors, let me know. Now, I know about Indian groups that are Moors, but I don't know about no Cherokee Indians. Now, please do not send me different black Indian groups that say that they're Moors unless they're Cherokee. I want to hear somebody that's Cherokee say the same thing that this lying motherfucker just said.
Ishmaelites, the haplogroup are Indians, and that's why, and the black Indians, the Cherokee, and the branches that come out of them, and that's why they're calling themselves the Moors and Muslims, because they are converts into that. That they did bring that Muhammadism with them, and for, you know, as they traveled.
This is little punk's Shem channel. So this is where this little bitch pretend he's an Israelite, right? Now on the other channel, he says I'm with Islam, and y'all ain't my brothers and shit, right? This is what this little punk says. Come to Crenshaw or whatever the fuck he says, right? Now you got him under a whole different persona. Oh, I'm Israel, QDNA, right? This is what he said at the end of his last channel, and then he said, "Oh, please unsubscribe," and then he fucking cries. Oh, by next year, I might have 100-something subscribers. I might have my subscription doubled. This is what this fucking guy cares about. And then you have to check his comments on other fucking pages for him to say, "I am pleased that I tricked people." If you find people that are tricked, that Haya and Allah are the same, I did that. I get credit for that. That's what that fucker said. Let's listen to Dog Meat.
With the Turkmen and Ishmael. You get it?
Hey, that's funny, because you're QDNA. And you're sitting here saying Q this and Q that is fucking Edom. But on film, you say you're Q. How are they fucking Q and they're Edom, but you're Q and you're not Edom? Huh? See, I don't understand that. See, because Ishmael is from Abraham. These Turks, they're from Abraham. See, so you should be like, "Oh, there's Turks. That proves that they're Edom. And Edom's blood should be connected to Israel." See, this should be your argument. But that's not your argument. That has never been your argument. Because just like the Israelites fucked other groups fucked other groups. So even if you have Israelite blood, how do I know you weren't raped? How do I know that you're not Edom raping into Israel? How do I know that you're not Moab raping into Israel? See, this is the fucking game you can play. If you can sit there and point to any of these fucking things and pretend that they're a biblical name. Look, Sin, oh, that is a biblical name. Mongol is not. This guy purposely chooses Turk, Q2, Turkmen, but don't know how to link it to the Bible. What is wrong with him? Obadiah shows you that the mighty men of Edom, the mighty men of Edom, are the Otiman, or the Ottoman. Ottoman Empire is a Turkish empire. Turks are Edom. Edom is related. Edom went into other blood groups. When Isaac said, "Do not go into the Canaanite," Edom purposely did. Now here you are, and I've got plenty of film on you already teaching wicked lies. Now I have to ask, is Q3 Edom? Is this blood group you claim to be Edom? Because of all the actions that you've done. You didn't start teaching to teach the truth. You fucking teach lies. And you want high fives when people fall for your lies. You goddamn sinner.
Also, the last part is Moab and Hagarenes. Moab is Q as well.
Where does anything on this fucking earth tell you that? I'd like to see it for myself.
And, that's Moab, Utah. That's an easy one.
Oh, so it's Moab, Utah. So the Hagarenes have to be there because you use this Bible scripture out of fucking context. The Hagarenes couldn't be on their fucking land in a bond with the people of Edom, in a bond with the tabernacle of Edom. No. Because when an idiot reads the Bible, you get an idiot's degree. This idiot says the tabernacle of Edom is at Moab, and the Ishmaelites are at Moab, and the Hagarenes are at Moab, because this motherfucker's an idiot.
And the Hagarenes. Who are the Hagarenes? Hagarenes are haplogroup C. And when you go to the haplogroup C...
Where is the fucking text that shows you this? Show me the text that shows you any fucking haplogroup going back to a biblical fucking name. You're a liar.
If I had the choice, you'd know what I'd do to you. I'd leave you like Abraham left those Canaanite kings. When he was told to make sure you cut them down before the sun goes down. You're a fucking liar. Your goal is to push souls in the opposite direction. You're an anti-magnet. Something's positive, you are negative. I say, look, the Bible literally says what? Utah. Literally says all the cities. Other people get on this internet. They use what? The same thing you're using, Google Earth, and show you all these biblical cities highlighted it in what? Utah. And here you are, like the goddamn devil, peeking your fucking horn out from behind a corner. And what's your goal, devil? What has always been your goal, devil? To stop the children, devil? I know who the fuck you are. I'm not blind. Like father, like son. When you show that goddamn picture of your daddy, ain't that a goddamn jailhouse picture? You fucking son of a thief. Like father, like motherfucking son.
Up here for the, for the Native Americans. Indigenous Indian haplogroups of the Americas, you can see where they're situated in the Northwest. Northwest, Canada, but these are not totally haplogroup C. I'm just saying where haplogroup C is, which is your out of Psalms 83 and 6, which are your Hagarenes. So it's telling you, right?
How can that be? How can the people of Canada be Hagarenes if there ain't no fucking written evidence? The Bible doesn't talk about haplogroup fucking C, you son of a fucking convict. What'd your dad get convicted for? I don't even like fucking saying that. Something urges me to say that.
There, who our enemies are, and right now, I find it extremely ironic that they plan on going to Utah.
Now, you heard this punk bitch just call me his enemy.
Who my enemies are, and they're planning on going to Utah.
Who our enemies are, and right now, I find it extremely ironic that they plan on going to Utah all together. Yeah, your haplogroup R. Your haplogroup R, which...
Now listen, this man is telling you the DNA of people that haven't even taken DNA tests. Do you understand that? This motherfucker is mythical. I guess he's telling you my DNA. I guess if you're watching and you want to go to Utah, he's telling you your DNA. If you didn't get a DNA test, he knows your fucking DNA, even though you and me have not gotten your fucking DNA tested. Listen to this fucking wizard.
Haplogroup C.
The shaman of Shem, right?
Saying where haplogroup C is, which is your, out of Psalms 83 and 6, which are your Hagarenes. So it's telling you right there who our enemies are, and right now...
That's the only thing it told you. Now you need to use a fucking book, an encyclopedia, a dictionary, to understand those names more. Not just fucking open a map and point and open your fucking mouth like you speak the fucking truth, when historically we have already shown you speak lies. Who's your father? Who's your daddy, motherfucker?
I find it extremely ironic that they plan on going to Utah.
These people online that I sit and watch every video of, because I don't have a goddamn life, I find it ironic that they're planning on going to Utah. And then he quotes that we are his enemies.
All together. Yeah, your haplogroup R. Your haplogroup R, which is Lud, who were forced into Islam.
Now, all of a sudden, haplogroup R is Lud. Now, before, haplogroup R1B is Chad, which it says on the DNA map, which you can't get around because it's even come out of his mouth. Now, he just picked a fucking name out of the Bible. Oh, they're Lud.
Your haplogroup R, which is Lud.
Now, okay, what happens when... See, this is the problem. How can people listen to this motherfucker?
Haplogroup R.
Oh, descendant subclads are common throughout Europe. Okay, so, again, even though it's R, and it's not R1, right? R1. Let's just look at R1. Look, R1B is right underneath that. We don't even have to click R1B. It's easy to find out if somebody's lying to you. Haplogroup R1. Let's look at R first. Oh, we looked R. Let's look at R1. Here, let's just put those in order. I'm so excited. I just want to... Common through Europe. R. Common through Europe. R1. Eurasia. R2. Eurasian groups. R1 and R1B. What the fuck's the point looking at R1B? It's still Eurasians. R1B. Western Europe. Russia. We just looked at this, right? Central Africa. Chad and Cameroon. Then what is this fucking crackhead talking about?
Who were...
All Europeans.
Now, I find it extremely ironic that they plan on going to Utah.
Let's get that back again. Let's get the mix off. Get rid of that. We gotta go into that. That's another one. We can do that one too, because that shit is just funny as hell. Me and my wife laughed at these motherfuckers. They talk so much shit about me. You hear some dishes banging in the background. This motherfucker said that must be his caretaker. Shit, dude. I'm excited. I can't wait to get to that one. All right, so we saw that shit about the Aztecs and the Utes, right? The Utes and the Utos. Even though we didn't bring up information to show the difference between the UTO and the UTE, we will. Now we're dealing with this R1 and this R1B. R1, common throughout Europe, right? It's even found in, and also common in parts of West Asia, Africa, and North America. So don't think I'm just trying to say, oh, it's only in Europe. When you look at R1, it comes from fucking Chad. This motherfucker made a video saying Chad must have to do with Nezichenezer. So when he says R1 comes from Nebuchadnezzar, and freaking R does too, right? Like, come from where? Fucking Asia, Africa, where? Where's the fucking paragroup? Subclass versus the parent, right? Hit the parent. I know it says para. Malta. Motherfucking Malta. Where did the Canaanites go when they fucking left? Yeah, I know it's Maltia, right? It's something different, right? It just said they left and went to Malta. I don't give a fuck if it's Maltia. I don't care if it's Malta. I don't care if it's the Knights of Malta. I don't care if it's the Knights of Maltia. I don't care. Venus figurines proves they were there. Where'd they bring Venus from? It's fucking African Canaanite worship. Right? See, you can connect this shit. Real simple. Without making shit up. So now, we're his enemies, right? Because we're going to Utah, and now all of a sudden, even though we haven't been DNA tested, we must be R1B. I mean, R1.
But he
doesn't even say R1, he just says R. We must be R. Because haplogroup R is present all over the fucking world. Right? Haplogroup R is present in Europe. Common throughout Europe. Central Asia and South Asia. It's also common in parts. It's common in parts. Not in the whole. See, throughout Europe means it's common in the whole of Europe. Common in parts of West Asia. So it's common all over South Asia, common all over Central, common in parts of West Asia, common in parts of Africa, common in parts of North America, right? So even though we're spread out all over North America, viewing these videos, wanting to go to Utah, knowing that there's people in fucking Illinois that want to go to Utah with evidence in Illinois that the Israelites were in Illinois. There's evidence that the Israelites were in Ohio. The fucking Ten Commandments were found here. There's evidence that Ten Commandments were found in New Mexico as well. So all those places, I would expect, quote-unquote, Israelite haplogroups to show up. Even though, at this point in history, those are untitled. The haplogroups are untitled what belongs to Israel. There's nothing you can find except for Ashkenazi lies
that says Israel anything. They themselves have our fucking R1A blood. And in the last video, we just showed what haplogroup they come from. Whether I can't remember what it is right now, and I took that one off the screen. But I connected it to the bottom of the last video. And let's listen to this freak again. Because we're going to Utah, because we've read the Bible, we have found in Scripture that it is for us to unite. For the second Exodus, this motherfucker wants to, what, stop us from going? Block the pathway? There's an open sidewalk. He wants to throw stones on the sidewalk so people trip. He wants to put bricks on the sidewalk. He wants to put cars on the sidewalk so people have to go around or climb over. Anything to make it harder.
These are not totally haplogroup C. I'm just saying where haplogroup C is, which is your, out of Psalms 83 and 6, which are your Hagarenes.
And again, so, Psalms 83 and 6, Psalms 83 and 7, Psalms 83 period does not classify haplogroups. Again, there is no literature that you can take and show that the Bible matches with this haplogroup or that haplogroup as of yet. Not for the layman.
It's telling you right there who our enemies are. And right now, I find it extremely ironic that they plan on going to Utah all together. Yeah, your haplogroup R. Your haplogroup R, which is Lud, who...
Okay, so you hear these lies? So when we read in Deuteronomy that this land was seized from those people groups and given to the Israelites, we must have accidentally found it. There must not be anything that has to do with our blood or DNA that has to do with the holy children of the Bible. We must be disgusting fuckers, and we accidentally stumbled onto Utah, and we started saying, hey, we should go to Utah to clean ourselves up. So this guy, who doesn't respect the Bible, doesn't respect where it literally says, I give this to the children as a possession. When it says that and he doesn't respect it, he sits here and makes a video to what? To the black community, right? This is what he does. Right in your face. Now I have to ask, why do you accept this? Why does a fucking eight people say, okay, well, he cleared that up for me?
Yeah, your haplogroup R. Your haplogroup R, which is Lud, who were forced into Islam and brought that.
So now there must be some kind of reading material that tells us that Lud was forced into Islam. L-U-D was forced into Islamic slavery. Can somebody show me that? If it exists, I just want to read it. Our goal here at Planet Lexwill is the truth. Period. This is why I'm so fired up over this shit.
And over here, claiming to be Moors, when really they're not the real Moors. Wow, this is amazing. So Uto Aztecan, let me get the Uto Aztecan again, because I think that's probably the most damaging part about this whole
Here's the most damaging part. He done said in a video he got qDNA. If he's calling these people Edom, doesn't that make him Edom? Like, wouldn't all of Edom, as long as it stems from the male seed, have some form of qDNA? Wouldn't Ishmael have a different DNA besides, you know, Edom? Wouldn't Ishmael have a variation of Abraham's DNA. Ishmael and Isaac's DNA would be, you know, different. Ishmael, wouldn't his DNA be different from the Israelites, since he's not, you know, part of Judah? I'm just trying to understand. Because when I look at it from the perspective of how the scripture is written, Isaac and Ishmael are going to have the same father but different mothers. So then there's going to be a percentage gap there. See, Isaac's wife, now I'm even going to go there. So then when we go to the next set of people is Edom and Jacob, right? Isn't Edom's DNA going to be half and half from a while back, because the first thing he did is start mating with Canaanites, a blood group that's not his own? Didn't he make himself kings, dukes and duchess in other kingdoms and mix with their DNA to rule over their people? So ain't his blood going to be mixed down some more? See, this is what we don't respect. We don't respect the Bible and what the Bible actually says. This queer took one fucking line and said all these people must live in this area. Now, slavery doesn't happen, and these people obviously must not have been affected by slavery. From his standards, they're still in the fucking area. From his standards, those people are Q and we're R. Now you heard him. On screen, Aztecs are Q. So first he's like, these guys have no relation to the Aztecs. And then he states that we are R1 because his fucking magic wand just knows. We're R DNA.
Still here. Let's get it. The Uto Aztecan. Christ. Right here. Uto Aztecan, Mexico and Arizona, 93.4% M2, because they're not M3.
Now, he's at 6 minutes in, and he's repeating the same thing he said in the fucking first 3 minutes. The first minute, the second minute, and the third minute. He has not once proven anything. If he wanted to say Aztec or QDNA, and he's related to Aztec, he could very well say that, because he's got Q3 DNA. Because he showed or read or told what he got back in the mail by spitting in a fucking glass jar. So technically, if they're Edom, then he's Edom.
Okay, M3 is represented. M1 is not up here. I think M1 is Moab. Moab, and that's...
Okay, see how fucking stupid this guy is? This guy has done these fucking videos over and over and over again. This is QM3, QM2. That's what this shit means. It don't mean M3. Oh my God, this guy is dumb.
On the other side of the world. Could be some over here, but... wow, this is just really, really amazing. Uto Aztec. So it's letting you know Utah is where your Aztecs.
Now it says, now we already know Aztecs were in Utah. It says Arizona. So he's adding shit to it doesn't even say. And he's failing to state that he's related to them.
Reigned. Wow. And the Aztecs are Edomites.
So he must be an Edomite. See, he must know his secret history. He must be just adding that, right? Now, here's the thing that trips me out. Now, he's a stupid motherfucker. Now, he could have made a very tight argument for he's Israel. But he's stupid. And tomorrow, I'm not accepting this. Now, here you have the Seminole Indians, right? The Seminole, the Muskogean branch. Now, again, of Seminole Indians, there's many branches. As we just saw with the Aztec, they record three branches here. Now, the Muskogean, 45% Q, straight 50% R1 DNA. See, it goes C, Q, and R. Other, they don't want you to know. This is the categories that we fall under. Other. They're not telling you about no fucking Afro people here. That's why they only got fucking three Aztec fucking branches. Now, again, pay attention to what this clown says. Now, he says they're EDOM, right? With no evidence, but he has qDNA. So he's related to all these people that are thick in this center fat column. That's what he's not telling you. So if he says they're EDOM, then I say he's EDOM. Since he can't prove shit, he just repeats shit.
Wow. Now, I wanted to research for people, not just haplogroup Q people, for all people that were interested in what I thought about Utah. And even if you're not, but if you're listening to this video, I guess you are. But the reason why I don't think Utah is a good idea.
No, I'm gonna tell you. Let me tell you this straight. Let me tell you face to face, or as close as we can get to face to face. You see me read this Bible, you can read this Bible on yourself, on your own. Deuteronomy 32, the whole chapter, tells you the fucking conquest and how they got the land. 34 tells you again. It repeats. So you're not confused. That land belongs to the Israelites. Does not matter who lived there prior. The prior names show exactly where the land is. That's the beauty of it. Now, the Mormons tell you they came in and they named everything, which they didn't. Because you can see by their quote-unquote treasures that they found that it's all of Israelite heritage. This Nephi is a city there. The people groups that he talks about, the Lamanites and the Jaredites and these things, whether they're part of Israel or not is to be determined from study of the Mormon text. Now, this Joseph Smith found shit in New York when he got off the boat, and then he made his way, found some shit in Illinois, and it's amazing how he keeps finding things along the route that he takes. It's as if the first thing that he found was a map to find all these other things. And then he ends up in Utah, right where the Bible says the children of Israel's home is. Now, it'd be simple to understand if he's not going by the Bible, he's going by a map that says the same thing as the Bible does. And this is what people, to a great degree, don't want to understand. You heard those people, you didn't hear the new one, these guys on this this video, the Nightmare Podcast, they do like a mystery science theater type shit, they just sit back and they make fun of other people's videos and shit. And when they're trying to make fun of my video, the co-host, he watches all the videos. He says something of that nature already. I do a headbang kind of blow up kind of that a lot. So he's watched a lot of videos where I go, okay, so you can tell that he watches. And the way that they display my video is as if he wrote down the times at where he wants to mystery science me, so I mean, it is what it is. But we'll be getting to that pretty soon.
But it's just like them. It's like when they do their shtick on me, they leave out the parts. Okay, when I say locusts in the video, they go, "Oh, there's locusts everywhere." But when I read from the biblical scholars explain that the term locust is used, is talking about the canker worm and the palmer worm, which is also called the pilgrim worm. When you go to the canker worm, only in America. When you go to the palmer worm, that's right, only in America. When they use the word pilgrim, it's only here. When they say pilgrimage for Jerusalem, I'm sorry, if you don't understand, that means here. When they say pilgrims came, that means here. When they say Inquisition of Americas, that's here. Inquisition means accept my God or die, accept Jesus Christ or die. You know how many fucking people died? Billions. Billions died, and we done fucking repeopled this continent enslaved. They sent home for more people, and we done grown by fucking. Look. This is the dumbest fucking type of person ever. As a deterrent to keep you from your reward, he makes a lot of stupid fucking lies. Now he's gonna show you Utah prison. Remember, you're going to Utah to attempt to be righteous, to attempt to cleanse yourself away from major cities where it's easy for you to get sex, drugs, easy for you to get in trouble. So the first thing this dumb motherfucker says, oh, I'm sorry, the last thing this motherfucker says is, let's look at America's hardest prisons, Utah. Well, of course, if black people are there before it's time to be there, then they gonna be encaged. But when it's time to go, it is time. Now, you can let these people keep making these dumbass videos. And that's your thing. But if you've donated, these people are literally against where you're putting your money. I would suggest you not participate in any thumbs up or any thumbs down or any viewing. If you desire to go to Utah and you don't have money, you're welcome to come. This is not a Lexwill party. I've shown you over and over again, it is yours as a possession. You've been separated from it by your oppressor that is occupying your country. I can't put it into sweeter words. Your occupier separated you from your home world, homeland, during conquest. He used your brothers, your cousins, people that you were intermingled with, people that you warred with. If you were too tough, they decimated you with disease. Each one of these Indian groups you read about, their hierarchy was taken down by disease. Even in Utah, the Black Hawk War. Black Hawk dies by disease. Black Hawk goes and tells all the tribes, after warring with the whites for like 10 years, he goes and tells all the tribes, just let it die, just let it die. And then what happens? They get him. By what? Disease. So, let's listen to this clown and wrap it up, because I don't like spending that much time on somebody that I don't like, but the form of evil that this fucktwat pushes forth is bad, because there's a lot of us that are not very educated.
And there's a lot of us that are lonely. And we'll do anything for a fucking friend. We've got to buck up. There's nobody by you for a reason. Because once you are trained and once you are skilled, you're going back out into the world to preach and teach unto the nations. You're going to be alone. Get used to it. There's nothing wrong with being alone. Soon you will have others near you. Patience. We're not going to Utah to get thrown in fucking Utah State Penitentiary.
This is probably the biggest one right here, because I'm like, Utah. And I'll just show you.
Right, because he hasn't taken the time to read the scripture. He's taken the time to watch the videos. And when I say I'm going to read from this Bible, open up your Bible so that you have your own form of understanding and you can highlight and you can see it for yourself and you can stop the video and you can keep my voice out of your head as you read it for yourself for self-understanding. This person did not do that. They listened, they watched, and deceit grew in them. Everybody watched me use Farrakhan. And Farrakhan says what? This guy loves Farrakhan. What Farrakhan say? You've got to go. So when you have the measles, you have to isolate yourself. When you are sick, you have to isolate yourself to cure yourself. And what does this ass clown want? He wants to poison you while you're at the hospital. What does he want? He wants to detour the ambulance from taking you to the hospital. What does he want? He wants to cut your phone line so you can't dial 911 to get to the hospital. He does not want you healed. He does not want you to seek treatment. Our treatment is spiritual. Our spiritual treatment lies in our homeland. I cannot help that. You saw me read it. You said, fuck, I don't believe this. You read it yourself. You read it over and over again. You rubbed your eyes in astonishment. It really says Moab. It's really talking about the desert. There's really a mountain. Go up to the highest peak of that mountain. There's really a mountain with many peaks, and there is one highest peak. It's called Mount Nebo. It is part of a mountain range called Mountain Abram. It does lie in Utah. It was given to you as a possession. This is witnessing someone go against scripture to actually try to... This motherfucker's as bad as the bushes. He's literally trying to prevent you from fulfilling scripture. This devil is trying to intimidate you so you don't fulfill prophecy.
Right here, you're looking at America's hardest prisons, Utah State. They have a big gang problem here. Okay, the gang problem is with the area, with all of these gang people in the prison go to these gangs, and the Aryans, haplogroup R, the white ones, and
right, the white ones. So he knows there's a difference between the white Aryans. I mean, the R1. R1 DNA of white people and R1 of black people. Come on, motherfucker.
Your Hispanic gangs. The Aryans try to assimilate the Hispanic gangs. Why? Because they're Edomites.
No, they don't. You're fucking lying. Mexicans want to join the fucking Nazis. The Nazis say the only problem is you're not white.
Mexicans try to join the Aryan gangs. They say, you're not white. That's why you have a white Aryan gang and a Mexican gang. You're a fucking liar. I mean, watch a goddamn prison TV show.
And this has been a big problem in California.
I mean, why am I even saying that? Ask your motherfucking daddy. Ain't this your dad right here? Ain't this motherfucker locked up? Ain't the whole goddamn internet seeing his fucking crime? Fuck you.
Two is the Aryan Nations and the Hispanic gangs click up and go against the guerrillas. That's the black gangs. If y'all don't know prison talk, I don't know. I guess my history is peeking its ugly head. But
motherfucker, you proudly show your fucking history. Don't even try that shit.
These are guerrillas. I mean, there are no in Utah. There are no guerrillas in there, and the blacks are the Crips. And so the blacks are either the guerrillas or the Crips, and they're going to explain some of that right now.
But the biggest challenge in this prison: controlling gangs. Out of nearly 4,000 inmates, over 1 in 4 have gang ties.
Problem with having gangs inside an institution is they start to click up. They start to develop their own little societies inside the prison. They start to get involved in the smuggling trade.
Yeah, they start to click up just like they do on the outside. It's the same thing. So if someone's telling you to go to Utah, I'm trying to tell you, you have to know the climate of that area.
Okay, I'm gonna try my hand at
Ain't that what a magician says? Ain't that what a wizard says?
Okay, I'm gonna try my hand at Hold on. I'm gonna try my hand at a personal testimony. Now, my personal testimony is gonna be a little bit different than what you guys are used to. My personal testimony, I'm going to start off with, I say, being a Muslim. I'm going to try my hand at a personal testimony. Now, my personal testimony is going to be a little bit different than what you guys are used to. Being a Muslim.
So why the fuck does he give a fuck what you're doing? As you're trying your hand at being an Israelite.
And what prisoners are being housed in there, because those same
prisoners must be being housed in the goddamn desert. What fucking difference does that make to anybody going to Utah? How many people go on a trip to Utah and they say, hey, let's stop at the fucking prison?
Prisoners do get out, and more likely than not, the poorest people in society are going to have to deal with these people.
Oh, yeah, because what? You know, prisoners get out of fucking Utah State Penitentiary where it's hot as fuck, and they say, hey, let's go to the fucking desert.
Are career criminals. You know,
hey, what are you going to do when you get out of jail? I'm not. I'm a career criminal.
So, long story short, don't go to Utah.
Because career criminals are going to come and steal from poor people in the desert. Right.
Don't dig up anything.
Oh, so now it has to do with digging. Did you just fucking hear what this little punk piece of shit said?
Go to Utah. Don't dig up anything.
That's what it's about.
Don't dig up anything.
That's what it's about.
Don't dig up anything.
That's what it's about.
Don't dig up anything.
This little punk bitch don't want you to go and find your fucking heritage. Stay scattered, stay lost.
Why? Who benefits if you're fucking lost?
Say, being a Muslim.
Muslims benefit with your ass being lost. Right?
Don't go to Utah. Don't dig up anything. Stay home with your families.
Stay home where they're gonna go door to door and take your ass into fucking FEMA camps. I ain't saying there ain't no FEMA camps in Utah. You know what's happening if you stay home. What does this scripture say? They're going door to fucking door. Who? The police? No. Who? The government? No. Fucking hoodlums. While they're raping your neighbor and you're fucking watching and wondering how many of them you can pick off, then here comes, what'd they say, gangs gang up, gangs team up during those kind of times, then two local street gangs team up and fuck, rape, and pillage your block. And this guy says, stay home with this safe hot water.
Long story short, don't go to Utah,
stay at home. Where you're already in that zip code that they're already chemically treating you to sterilize you.
Don't dig up anything.
Don't dig up anything. Yeah, don't dig up anything in Utah. Because why? The Mormons dug up stuff and built a whole church off somebody else's history. Don't go to Utah and dig up your whole history and have the Mormons return your history to you. Don't go to Utah, because there's prisons there. And when there's prisons, prisoners get released in prison states. There's a prison in Ohio. Do we have a desert in Ohio? No, but we have things close to a desert. When prisoners get released in Ohio, do they go to the woods? No, they go back to cities. Yeah, let's see. When prisoners get released in Utah, do they sit there and say, hey, what are you doing when you get out of fucking prison? Oh, I'm going into the desert to steal and rape and pillage poor people. And the prisoner says to him, what can you make off of poor people? Right? That's the punchline. This is a fucking joke.
Stay home with your families. If you don't have family, start a family in your life. Don't be paranoid because the Brahmin haplogroup R, Lud.
Come on, man.
Lexwill.
Oh, here we go. So now I'm Lud. Oh, he says my name now.
Lud, Lexwill is on a power trip.
No, okay, so now I'm on a power trip. So when I grab the Bible and I read the Bible to you, that's a power trip. When other people take that Bible and open what? Google Earth and show you exactly where those cities are, that's called a power trip. That isn't my video. That's their video. They must be on a power trip too.
That's what he's going to do. He's going to find some women, and I do mean... only women to follow him to do this crazy idiotic stuff. I used the scripture I showed you on the DNA map.
He used one line of scripture taken out of context. He showed you a haplogroup scripture map with absolutely no biblical names on it. None. He just pointed and said, that's Edom. It actually says Turkmen, and Turks are Edom to some classification. But that's got to be proven on paper by the people that do the DNA. Because we have no idea if they're just lying about if that's Turkmen. On top of that, your DNA is Q also, so that means you share the Turk's blood. I don't think Edom shares Israel's blood that way. I don't think they slept together. I think they were born together and then went their separate ways. Now look at you, sitting there saying, don't go back to your homeland.
On the DNA map, what's going on here? I mean,
You mean what? Oh, okay. You fucking stop mid-sentence? Let's go back to this.
Family, live life.
Yeah, let's go back to this.
Don't dig up anything.
There we go. So a couple of things were said in this video, and it showed a couple of holes in these two, whatever the fucking these motherfuckers are.
I want y'all to listen to this video. It has to deal with Montezuma's gold. It's very important because there's a lot of people that is claiming to be from the tribes of Yaqub, from the tribes of Israel, when indeed they are not. And if you guys don't know by now, 60% of you guys are Canaanites. Yes. Wow.
Now, you hear, he's just saying exactly what this fucking moron says. He's just repeating him. That's all he's doing.
15% of you guys are Assyrians. And less than 15%.
Shut the fuck up.
My ancestors' things.
Listen to this guy.
And you guys, if you cross that line, search for Montezuma's gold, trying to search for Moses, or search for Montezuma's gold, or search for the Ark of the Covenant, because this might happen to you guys if you cross that line and try to mess with my ancestors. So you guys need to listen up on this before you guys think about going to Utah.
So you hear one Muppet talking shit, right? And now listen to this fucking queer again, right?
Don't go to Utah. Don't dig up anything.
Right? Now, let's listen to this fucking retard. Hey, where's the stuttering bumbling?
And trying to search for Moses, or search for Montezuma's gold, or search for the Ark of the Covenant, because this might happen to you guys if you cross that line and try to mess with my ancestors' things.
The fuck is... So, alright, you see this stag, elk, blah blah blah? This is this fucking Khalil too. Right? Every time we see this stag, elk talking shit, he says something that this stupid fuck says, right?
Stay home with your families.
Listen, hold on.
If you don't have family, start a family. Live life. Don't.
Right, he says
don't,
that.
Don't.
He just says, live life, start a family, right?
Because,
and this guy, this one sits around fucking holding cats on camera because he's lonely. Right? You two fucking teamed up to fucking attack me and my goddamn people?
The Brahmin haplogroup are Lud. Lexwill is on a power trip. Okay, that's what he's going to do. He's going to find some women, and I do mean only women.
All right, let's stop right there. Let's stop right there. Take a second. Let's go to this dumb motherfucker's videos again. All right, because he makes a fucking statement. Right now, you can see if I watch the video, it'll say watched. Right, or if I looked at a video, it'll say watched. Haven't watched. Haven't watched. Haven't watched. Here's the one I'm looking for. I need evidence, right? That's the one I want. I'm gonna put that open. I've watched that. That one's been opened, right? None of these have been opened. This motherfucker goes on camera for an hour. You're watching my videos. I don't fucking watch you, you bumbling fucking idiot. You make me so goddamn sick. I talked to you one time. One time. Through fucking text. What the fuck did I say? Hey, just keep reading Mysteries of the Mexican Pyramids. All that other shit you're doing is fucking stupid. But you think I'm spending my day watching your fucking videos? What the fuck are you gonna say that I can't read for my fucking self? I encourage people to read these books. Especially if people aren't going to read. But if you're going to sit there and make fucking videos against me, I'm definitely not gonna skip over you, fucktard. I'm definitely not gonna skip over you. So when we look at this video that this mutt put up, his little girlfriend comes in with his second fucking, with his second account. Now here's the fucking homo that sits around with numerous accounts. Thirty-two comments on this. And we scroll down and look at these comments. I heard if you keep a corpse at a certain temperature. Where'd you hear that? Reading your Babylonian Bible? He also said he will be in charge of a village, which I guess it makes sense considering that his campaign and all. He said anyone crosses his commands will be done away with. But I personally believe he's just saying that the men who try to cross him, that he has a soft spot for black women, especially Miss Remington, whoever the fuck that is. Isn't this the same thing? Now, if I look through all these fucking comments, he will say the same thing. He will set up a settlement with women only. Even if he goes for male-governed society. Now, think. Even if he goes for a male-governed society based on what? Now, let's go back to what this guy just said in this other video, right?
Gonna do. He's going to find some women, and I do mean... only women to follow him to do this crazy idiotic stuff.
So you see what's going on? He's got a second persona, which he has not enough sense. Let's just get this fucktard off anyway. Not enough sense to change the things he's saying. He says the same things here that he says on film. Now, and it turns out that they've got that concept from the 12 tribes, and several of Lex's followers have wives that are not Hebrew. You have a wife that's not Hebrew as well. See, this is the part where you need to just shut the fuck up. You've already crossed the line with me a while ago. A while ago, and you just don't know it yet. I feel we're gonna meet. I truthfully feel that we are. And just to make you want to meet me, I'm gonna talk some more shit. Now let's hold on for a second.